Steve Froggatt, first time back for a long while. Why is it taking so long then?
I think working for the media for the last 19 years, I've always been at games or working away, so I'm having a sabbatical from that for a year, and it's great to be back here today. My boy's been, who's 21 now, has been badgering me to come back to here for a long, long time, so I think it's much for him as for me today.
And you played at Coventry during a great period. What are your fondest memories of your time for the Sky Blues?
Oh, so many. Obviously, the lads, the group of lads we played with, you know, even going to the kit man Andy Harvey, who's here today, Noel Whelan, Darren Huckabee, you know, all the boys, Paul Williams. So I keep in touch with quite a few of the boys even now, you know, all these years later. I suppose the highlight, I mean, it'd have to be getting called into the England squad. You know, being on the bench at Hampden Park whilst, you know, being a Sky Blue, I think would obviously have to be a big moment for me during my time.
And of course, you know, go from highs to the lowest point of your career, where it all ended, sadly.
Well, cut off
in your prime.
It happened. I mean, the thing is, it's 19 years ago now, and you just have to get over it. And I know Nicky Summerby's had a lot of stick over the years, and I actually saw Nicky 2 years ago for the first time in 17 years. And I went up to him and I was commentating at the Etihad, and he thought I was going to hit him. And I went and shook his hand. And he said, I wasn't expecting that. I said, well, you can't live with bitterness your entire life, can you? I had 10 amazing years out of the game. I had 4.5 great years here. I had no complaints. It's a shame. It could have been so much better, but hey, you know, that's life, isn't it?
And your best game at Coventry has got to be the 4-1 win at Villa, hasn't it? Villa Park.
My best individual game, I think, would have been the Everton game. When we beat them 3-0 at Highfield Road. But yeah, obviously, I mean, the Villa game was a big one. You know, beating them 4-1 there. I mean, I suppose that would be the game remembered, I guess, more by the City fans than anything else, yeah.
And you played with some fantastic players during your time. Who was the best you had?
Oh, there's so many. I tell you, I'm going to go curveball. I'm going to say Roland Nielsen. And the reason I'm going to say he was an absolute Rolls Royce of a human being and a player. And I always wanted to train against him every day because I thought, if I get the better of him during training the week, then I'm on fire. I'm going to be great at the weekend because he was the best defender I ever played against. And I thought, if I could outdo him, there wasn't a defender in the country that I wouldn't get the better of. So I would say Roland, as much as, you know, there was Gary Mack, who was an amazing player, some wonderful players in the squad, Noel and Darren, of course. But I would say Roland because he was a class act both on and off the field.
Things are picking up, thankfully, on the pitch, and you know, promotion last season, pushing for the playoffs this season. Mark Robbins is doing a fantastic job. But does it sadden you that the club still got their off-field problems?
It's heartbreaking, Andy. It's for everybody to connect with the city, the football club. You know, the heads certainly need banging together, don't they? To get past this impasse. And you just hope that in the next few weeks they can resolve their issues and make sure there's still football in Coventry, because it's got so much heritage. You can see by how many ex-players have turned up today the importance it is still for the players and, you know, the supporters of the football club. So, you know, I think it could be a bit like Brexit, where there might be a deal done at the 11th hour. I'm hoping so anyway.